Hello, welcome to a new video about TMS Web Core for Visual Studio Code. In this video, we are going to see about the form designer and more specifically about the ways you have available to create components inside a form. For example, what you can do is if you select a component on the tool palette, you can click on any location in your form and the control will be created on that specific location. And also, if you create a component that is a container, for example, a panel, we are going to place that component there. You can click and select any component and click inside the container. Okay, so the component will be created inside that container. What happens if you try to create a control inside another control that is not a container? Let's see. If you click here, the control will be created on the same parent of that control that you have just clicked. Okay, so they share the same parent and same container. And the same happens if you create a control or you try to create a control inside a container that is inside the form. Okay, you cannot do that operation, but the form designer selects a valid parent for it. Another way for you to create a component is by double clicking. So if you have selected the form and you double click, the control will be created on the center of that container, in this case the form. But what happens if you double click again? Because there was already a control in that location, the designer shifts the location of the new control that is created so they don't collide and you see the result, so it's not confusing to you. That happens, you know, this way. So if I move those components here and I try to create again this will be created on the center because that location is free. Let's see what happens. For example, I'm going to move this control here, and I'm going to place this control here. This is a panel, so if I double click, okay, the control is going to be created on the inside the panel because that is the valid container that I have selected, and it works exactly the same as if this container was the form. So it works as expected, okay? So let's move this out. And another way for you to create controls is by clicking here, but dragging, instead releasing the mouse, you can drag, and this will draw a rubber band or a selection band that you can use in order to define the dimensions of the component you are going to create. Okay, so it's a nice way for you to select not only the location, but also the size of the control you are going to create. And the same works inside a container. So if I create the control here, okay, so that control will be created with the in the location I want, with the size I want inside the container I want. Okay, those are the ways for you to create controls inside your form designer, so you can define the user interface. But what happens when I create controls? What happens with the code? So let's see. We are going to reorganize this screen so we can see more, and I can show you better what I'm going to explain. The point is that when you create controls here, those controls, the fields, are added to the form class, so they will be available for you to write code. Okay, so every time you add a new control, the source that is behind, the source code that is behind this form is updated properly, so you can use those components right away. Another thing is that, for example, if you just pay attention to this users list, allows us to to use those components in source code, contain all the classes and methods and all the types that we need in order to use them. So if we drop a component that needs a unit, for example, let's see the mask edit, I think it was here. I'm going to search for it, mask. If I drop this control will be added, but also the unit that is that provides that functionality and that component. So you don't have to worry about adding any users list because the form designer will be doing that work for you. And there are another controls, for example, this one, okay, that when I add this control needs not just one unit on the users list, but also two units. Okay, so all that work, the form designer will be done on your behalf, so you don't have to worry about that. Also, for example, if we change this web button, the name for this component to another one, my button, okay, the unit, the source code will be changed also. The field will be renamed accordingly to reflect the name change that you have just performed. Okay, so also there is no need for you to worry about changing the source code and so on. And finally, there are components that are non-visual, client, socket client. These components are special in the sense that they don't have a visual representation. They are not buttons or UI elements that you can actually interact with, but they provide functionality. For example, a socket client is a way for you to connect to a socket and to read and write. And this component is a non-visual one. In order for you to interact and to be able to select them on the designer, they are represented by this iconic component. So you can click on them and select their properties here and change the name and so on. These components cannot be inserted inside containers because they are not non-visual, and also they cannot be resized, okay, because they are non-visual also. So that's it. I hope you like it. Thank you very much.